Tell the truth about your research. It may seem simple, but when higher-ups are breathing down your neck, resources have been spent, and pressure is high, it might be tempting to paint a rosy picture of results. But it's still important to recognize and communicate the limitations of your research findings. Overall, when delivering summary results to stakeholders, make sure to emphasize that the results we're presenting come from a study, not all users. Studies give us insight into the true nature of a user population, but we can't extrapolate past our participants. I've had plenty of managers that are eager for good results that confirm their expectations and internal biases. But that's not why we do research, right? Lots of times we find unexpected things from conducting research, and it's our responsibility to stand firm when communicating results that go against a stakeholder's gut instincts. For example, when delivering the results of a qualitative study, I might be tempted to say that users like the new design better. But my study, although useful, only included 5 participants. To be more responsible, I should say 5 out of 5 users tested liked the design better. The second, more transparent option provides more information and can work in our favor. For instance, reporting on the results of a qualitative study in this way could segue into discussion of next steps with analytics or a quantitative study. Even in quantitative studies, beware of too generously communicating results. Stick to including confidence intervals, error bars, or statistical significance with quantitative results. In fact, taking opportunities to educate stakeholders on the impact and importance of research limitations can benefit you and your business in the long run. After all, there are real costs to being overly rosy or generous with your research outcomes or insights. Your company might commit resources to a poorly informed decision because you felt pressure to report a successful test. Plus, misrepresenting one's data creates a reputational and credibility risk. Little exaggerations or extrapolations build up over time, leading to a reduction of trust in the research that we conduct. Transparency is always better for our credibility as researchers, warts and all. It is better to deliver an unsatisfying research report than to waste resources and trust by misrepresenting the limitations of research.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.